In this video, you're going to be learning how to create an Amazon affiliate website, very similar to the one that you're looking at right now. I've created one all around zombie products, but of course you can create one around whichever products you like. It's really easy to populate and hopefully should start earning you some commission before you know it. So let's waste no more time and roll the tape. It's Alex here from WP Eagle. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to set up an Amazon associate, otherwise known as affiliate, website. Now, for those of you that don't know, an Amazon affiliate is someone that promotes Amazon products on their own website. And then when a visitor to that website clicks through to Amazon and makes a purchase, the affiliate, i.e. you and me, after we've got our website set up, earns a small commission. So really good way to earn a little bit of extra money. Now, I've been running an Amazon affiliate website for over a year now, and it was something I just created when I had a little time a while back and kind of left it sitting there, just kind of not doing anything with it and just letting it fester, as it were. And I've checked my earnings for this month so far, and this is November 2015, and I'm already up to about £70, which in American dollars, I guess, would be over $100. As I say, so from a website that I haven't done hardly any work on recently, and it just kind of sits there. The website's called bootboutique.co.uk if you want to check it out. I'll put a link on the screen. Yeah, that's my old one. But today we're going to be creating a website, not about boots, about zombie merchandise, which was just something I randomly thought of because I really like the TV program The Walking Dead. So let me put it on the screen for you right now. This is the website that you're going to be making today. Obviously, it doesn't have to be about zombies. It can be about whatever products or whatever you're into. And it's powered by WordPress, and it's also powered by an amazing Amazon affiliate plugin. So this website, it looks really good on, obviously, a desktop, but it also works really well on a mobile phone because it's fully responsive. And the thing I really love about the plugin that we're going to use is that you can get products down from Amazon really quickly and populate your site. So it doesn't take too long to, you know, add hundreds and hundreds of Amazon products and fill up your website really quickly. Then, of course, each of these products, when someone adds them to a cart and goes off to the checkout, it inserts your Amazon affiliate details automatically, and then you're going to earn a commission. Now, I would like to stress with regards to earnings from Amazon, obviously, it's all very well setting up a nice website and putting it online, but there is going to be a little bit of extra work you're probably going to need to do in order to really get your earnings up, and that includes things like SEO and other promotions and blogging and all sorts of things like that. You may be lucky and you might be able to just launch it and hope for the best, but generally, and even on my Boots website, which I mentioned earlier, I did do a couple of blog posts and, you know, added some links to Pinterest and all that sort of stuff, which I do have other videos on my channel in terms of how you might want to SEO your website and get more traffic. Okay, before we get started, I need to let you know how much everything's going to cost. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need is website hosting. Now, hosting is basically a server on the internet, which is just a big computer, where your website lives. So obviously it's available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and people can access it from all over the world. I've got a voucher code that I'm going to give to you very shortly that allow you to get your first month of hosting for just a penny. Then obviously, depending on the package that you choose, there'll be another monthly fee going forward, but it's not going to be any more than a few dollars a month. The second thing we're going to need is a plugin, and the plugin is called Woozone, and that's what we're going to be using to get all our Amazon products onto our website and kind of manage all that kind of activity. The cost for that plugin is just $34, which is not a lot when you think about it. And for that, obviously, you get support and updates and all sorts of things. I've not found a free plugin that does what this one does. So, it is going to involve a small investment, which shouldn't be too bad because hopefully your Amazon affiliate site will start to bring in some revenue and cover those costs quite quickly. Final thing we're going to need is a theme to make our website look really nice. And I've chosen a theme that is specifically designed for this plugin. And again, that theme is a premium theme, so there is a small fee, and that's just $24 too. So that's all listed up on the screen, what we need, so you can see exactly how much we're going to need to invest. Not a lot, and hopefully if your Amazon affiliate website starts working quite quickly, you'll recoup that cost in no time at all. Okay, I think I've said enough in this intro. The video is quite long, so if you get stuck at any time, please just drop me a message. via the comments below this video or via my website at wpeagle.com, and I will do my best to reply and help you out. Also remember, because we're using premium products in terms of themes and plugins, if you do get any problems with any of them along the way, just drop them a line via their support system, and I found them to be very quick and very helpful in terms of their responses. So let's get started making our Amazon affiliate website. Good luck, get yourself a cup of tea or whatever, and let's get started.
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is set up our hosting, and for that I'm going to recommend a company called Hostgator. Now, hosting is basically where your website lives on the internet, and you basically hire a little bit of a server, and a server is a big computer, where you can install WordPress and put your website, and it's then available, obviously, to the world 24 hours a day. The reason I'm recommending Hostgator today is, A, because they're really, really cheap and give you a great service for a very low cost. Secondly, I find their support to be very good in terms of they're quick at getting back to you. If you've got any issues, you can contact them via live chat. And that's really important, obviously, when you're setting up a new website, that if there is any problems, which there often isn't, but if you do have a little snag or get stuck with something, you know, there's someone at the end of a live chat or on the end of the phone, depending on which package you go for, that you can get in touch with. But I find the live chat is just perfect. I don't really like ringing people personally. I like to just get on and just fire off a message and they sort it out that way. So yeah, that's why I'm recommending them today. I've got a voucher code that I'm going to let you know in a few minutes, which will get you your first month for just a penny. So there's not a lot you need to spend today on your hosting, and obviously there is a 45-day money-back guarantee. So if things don't work out for whatever reason, you can just cancel it, get your penny back if you want to. So to get started, we're going to click Get Started Now. And then if we scroll down on this page, we can see the different plans. Now, the hatcheling plan is generally fine for most people, but if you're thinking of maybe adding a few extra domains or something, or maybe a few extra websites, then you might want to go up to a baby plan or business plan. You can obviously change your plan or add extra plans in the future if you want to anyway, so don't worry too much about your decision now, and if in doubt, just go for the hatcheling plan. Now, there's a number of different options in terms of how you pay and how long you commit for, basically. So if you're not too sure, you know, how the website's going to pan out and you don't want to commit for very long, then just go for the monthly where you can, you know, you've only got a month's commitment and then you can get out if you need to. Let's click sign up now. And as I say, I've got a voucher code that's going to get that $8.76 down to just a penny. So the first step is we need to choose a domain. Now, if you don't already have a domain and your domain is like your .com and your .co.uk or your .net or your .whatever, and that's basically, you know, your name out there on the internet. If you don't have one already, then we need to register one. So you can just start typing in some words here. I'm just typing in some random names. And then you can select whether you want a .com or .club or .whatever. And what will happen is it will tell you if it's available and it will add it for you. And then it also suggests some other domain names that you might be interested in. Obviously, you don't need all them. Normally, one is sufficient. In this case, I actually already own my domain. I registered with another provider a little while ago, as you may have already done. You know, a lot of people do buy domains and then kind of worry about setting up websites later. If you've already got a domain, that's fine. You just need to click on this tab here. Enter your domain name in, and now the one I'm going to be using today, as you know from the intro, is called zombiemerc.com. And that's been added fine, and again, it's going to suggest some other ones if I want them, and I don't, so I'm just going to scroll down. The hosting plan we selected on the first page anyway, it's the hatchling, it's the 1 month commitment. In here, you enter in your username. Now, I'm not going to bother filling in all this form just now because I don't want to take up too much time, but obviously you enter a username. This is what you're going to log in into Hostgator with. And a security pin here, which is 4 to 8 digits, again, just for allowing you to log in and for technical support and all that kind of stuff. The third section is your billing info, so filling in your name, email address, and all that kind of stuff. And obviously your payment details, and you can pay with credit card or PayPal. Section 4 is additional services. Generally, I don't think you need these, so just untick them. The fifth section is the coupon code, which is very important because here you need to enter my coupon code, which is Eagle Penny, which will give you your first month for just a penny, as we can see. And I will add that I do earn a commission if you use that coupon code. So yeah, it's good for you, you get a discount, it's good for me, I get a little bit of cash for my hard efforts on making these videos. So much appreciated if you use my coupon code. Obviously, if you don't want to, that's fine. You don't have to. Okay, and then the final step is just to tick the box and click checkout now. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill in this form quickly during an edit, so you don't have to sit through watching me type in my credit card number and all that kind of stuff. And I will see you after I've done that and once we're all signed up and ready to start setting up our Amazon affiliate website. I'll see you shortly. Okay, so I filled in all the forms and everything and paid with PayPal, or if you want, you can obviously use a credit card. And what should happen now is your order will complete and you'll be logged in just like this. And you'll also need to go and check your email at this point. So I've got my inbox here. And you should have an email from HostGator, which looks something like this. And if you click through, it's got all the details that you need for you to be able to log in the future. So obviously you need to make a note of all this stuff or to keep this email safe. Now, the next step I'm going to do, obviously, because I already own the domain, and this applies to you as well if you already had a domain registered. It doesn't apply to you if you just registered a new domain with HostGator, so you can skip forward a little bit. I will put a link on the video right now that you can click just to skip this little bit. But if you, yeah, as I say, if you already had a domain registered with another provider, you just quickly need to follow these couple of steps, and that is to update your name servers. So I'm going to pop over to GoDaddy, who is my domain registrar, and visit my account. Now, obviously, depending on who you're with, this is going to be slightly different, but the principle is still the same. Basically, you need to log in, find the domain that you're going to be using. Mine is obviously the zombie one, zombiemerc.com. And you then need to go and manage it. And say it's going to be different depending on your company. If you use GoDaddy, it's obviously going to be the same. But if you're using maybe Namecheap or 123 Reg or any of those guys, the principle will still be the same. You need to change your name servers, which you'll see look like something like this. You see we've got them here, name servers. So I'm going to click manage, and then I'm going to select custom, and then I'm going to click edit custom name servers. And I say this will be different if you're with a different company, but the principle is the same. You need to update your name servers. And then I'm just going to copy and paste these two name servers in here. And then click OK. And then click Save. So that's all done. Now what I will say is if you have just registered a new domain or if you've just changed your name servers like I just did, that it can take a little while for these changes to be reflected. So don't panic if you go to your domain and you don't see anything there, you get like an error or whatever, that's fine, because it can take a little while for these changes to update. So wait a few hours, and then hopefully when you go to your domain name, you will see some sort of holding page or whatever appear, and then you're ready to carry on. So let's carry on now. Okay, so my name servers changed pretty much instantaneous. So now when I go to the domain name zombiemerc.com, I can see this HostGator page. So now I know that everything is kind of working and the domain is pointing at HostGator. And we're now ready to start setting up our website. So that's what we'll do right now. Okay, welcome back those of you that just registered domain and just skipped that bit that we just did for the registered guys that have already registered their domain. So I'm back at this email that you've hopefully got from HostGator. It can take a few minutes to come through if you haven't got yours yet, so don't panic. So in your email, you'll find obviously everything you need in terms of logins and stuff. So what we need to do is log into our control panel. I've just noticed that I've spelt my username wrong. I've put Zombie Merc. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Don't worry about that. If you've done a typo too, I doubt you have. I'm terrible with typos, as you'll see if you watch any of my videos. So I'm just going to copy and paste this username anyway so that I don't make any more typos. So I'm going to paste in the username and then come back and paste in the password. And we're logged in successfully. And what you'll see is this is your kind of main control panel. You might want to close all these annoying pop-ups. Now this site, and maybe save the password using your browser's password thing. Now don't be scared. I know that this control panel can look a little bit overwhelming. There's lots of buttons and things going on in here, but trust me when I say it's really easy. You're going to be fine. Just follow this video and you know everything is going to be fine. So the first thing we want to do is install WordPress because we're going to be building our site with WordPress, as you know. And luckily, Hostgator is a really easy way of installing that. So if you scroll down towards the bottom of this page, get past all this stuff, and what you're looking for is this here, which says quick install. And if you click on there, it comes to this kind of quick install page with this big green monster thing, which is fine. There's also a login over here, but you don't need to log in. There's a login up there. You don't need to log in. It's kind of a bit confusing that you don't need to worry about that. All we need to do is go over here and click WordPress. And then we need to click install WordPress. Okay, select your domain, which there should only be the one, I'd have thought. And you don't need to put anything in here. Down here, you need to put your email address in. And then you need to give the website a title, but don't worry if you can't think of one, just put something in there, we can change it later. You need to add a username for your, basically this is gonna be the login for your WordPress site, so it's gonna be the admin user. So I'm just gonna use my kind of handle. And then you need to put your name in. Then we can click install WordPress. And it's gonna go off and do some stuff. This is gonna, an advert thing's come up, just say no thanks, I'm a web designer. Well, you will be after you finish watching this video. And that should be all done. So up here, we've got a little thing that is very important, which is our credentials. And if you click on this little arrow, it shows you the username, which is what you already set, and then it shows you your password, which is very important. So I'm just gonna copy and paste this password. I'm gonna copy it to start with. I'm gonna click this link, which takes us to the WordPress login screen. The username is my handle thing, and then I'm gonna paste that password in. I'm gonna click remember me because it makes it just easier. And then I'm gonna click login, and that should take us into WordPress. Now the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change that password to something that's a little bit more easy to remember. So I'm just gonna go up here and go to edit my profile. Then I'm gonna scroll down. And you can click generate password, and it generates this really random long thing. And now I'm going to type in a password that I can remember. I'm just going to click hide so that you guys can't see what it is, you know, just in case. Not that I don't trust you or anything, but you can't be too careful, can you? So yeah, obviously change your password to something more friendly that you can remember, or keep the really long weird one if you want, but you probably have to write it down then, which makes it pointless anyway, doesn't it? Anyway, I'm rambling. Let's. The next step we need to do is just remove any plugins that aren't required, because when you install these things, it always installs some plugins and things that you don't really need. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tick here. We need Akismet. I'd recommend you keep that because that's good for spam. I'm going to tick Hello Dolly. I'm going to tick Hostgator Walk Me plugin. I'm going to tick the Jetpack by WordPress, and I'm going to tick the Mojo Marketplace. And then I'm going to come down to here to Bulk Actions, and I'm going to select Delete and Apply. Basically, I just want everyone to be on the same page and that we've all got nice, clean WordPress installs and just with Akismet, which you can set up later. Okay, so we're all there. If we go up here and click on Visit Site, and then refresh, this is our WordPress site, and it's got the default theme, and it's basically ready to start customizing and turning into an amazing affiliate site for Amazon. So let's get started on that. So the first thing we're gonna do is install a couple of plugins we need in order to facilitate the Amazon affiliate site. The first is an e-commerce plugin called Woocommerce, which is free, and that gives us the platform to, you know, show products as a checkout and a cart and all that kind of stuff you'd expect on an e-commerce site. And the second is a plugin called Woozone, which is gonna be our premium plugin that does all the cool stuff in terms of pulling products down from Amazon and adding our affiliate links and all that kind of stuff. So let's get started on that. So I'm still logged into the website. I'm gonna go over to the dashboard. Then I'm gonna go to plugins and add new. Then here, just type in WooCommerce and click install now. That's done, let's click activate plugin. Okay, so now we've got this wizard that we can go through, which is gonna help us set up our WooCommerce plugin. So let's click let's go. So it's gonna create some pages for us, which we're gonna need, which is all fine. So let's just click continue. Now it's gonna ask us currency and things like that. We don't really need to worry about this just now, but just leave it as it is, click continue. We're not going to worry about shipping and tax because obviously everyone's going to be going off to Amazon and they'll deal with all that business. So let's click skip. Payments again, Amazon are going to be doing that for us. So let's click skip this one. And then we're done. And if we just click down here, we can go back to the WordPress dashboard. So that's WooCommerce installed. The next plugin we need, as I said, is our premium plugin called Woozone. And for that, I'm going to head over to a website called Code Canyon, which I'll put a link up on the screen for. I'll put a link up, which will take you straight through to this plugin that I'm going to find, which is called Woozone. I just did a search there. And this plugin is really, really powerful and makes setting up an Amazon affiliate site really easy. So basically what it does is you put all your Amazon details in and then you can do a search via your backend for products on Amazon, and then it will download the images, the text, and it can spin the text a little bit if you want to make it unique. And then when someone clicks add to cart, it adds all the products to your cart and then they can go off to Amazon. So yeah, really powerful, really great. Check it out. There's all the details on this site here. There is a cost for it, like all good things. You have to pay a little bit of money and it's only $34, and I think that's really good value. And with that, you get 6 months support as well from the developer. So if you get stuck, they'll help you out, and you get updates as well. So they're always adding new features. So that's really useful too. I've already purchased it. You'll obviously need to sign up to Code Canyon if you aren't already, and deposit a little bit of cash. Just a quick note about the Envato marketplaces, including Code Canyon. I would suggest that you deposit about $60, because as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we're also going to need to buy a theme from here as well to help us make the website. And the total of that is going to be about $60. So yeah, you might as well just deposit that into your account. I think you get a discount if you do deposit rather than just buy it as it is. So yeah, worth doing, just a little tip there. And yeah, so let's get back to the video. I'm going to click here to download it. And I'm going to download it into here, that's fine. I've already downloaded it, I'm just going to click replace. So that's all done. And I'm going to show that in my Finder. So I'm looking at it on my computer. I'm just going to extract the zip file to see what's inside. So it extracted this little folder here called 8.3. whatever. It might be a slightly different number if you're doing it in later in the future, because there might be a different version, but it will look something like this. And within here, there's a folder called plugin. And within there, there is a zip file called Woozone, and that's the one we need to upload to our website. So I'm going to go into the website here. I'm still logged in. Obviously, I'm going to go to plugins and add new. Then I'm going to click upload plugin, choose file, go into that folder, go into the plugin folder, select Woozone, click open, click install. So that will just upload. Then we can click activate to turn it on. And here we go, we're ready to start setting it up. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is put in our purchase code, which you can find from Code Canyon. So if I go back to that, click on the support tab on the product page and scroll down, you find this code here, which I will blur out for security purposes. And paste that and click activate. And then we're done. Okay, so here's all our options, which we're gonna go through very shortly. But the next thing I want to do is install a theme. Now, plugin recommends that we use one of their themes, so that's what we'll do. And there's two to choose from, and I think I'm gonna go for this one called Kingdom. You see there's a link up here. But again, they're all on Code Canyon. And yeah, I really like the look of this theme. So I'm gonna have a go at setting it up. There's a few demos to look at. So, you know, for example, this gaming store might be similar to a zombie type store, maybe. Let's have a look. It's got a nice clean layout and it's got like a big slider thing and yeah, nice big product images. So I think it's gonna be perfect. So what we need to do is buy it. I haven't bought it yet, so I'm gonna click buy now. I'm gonna click buy now. I'll use some credit that I have. Okay, now I can download that theme. There we go. And similar to the plugin, we need to look at the file we've downloaded, click open with, or extract it as it were. I open it with the archive utility on a Mac. And then it creates this folder. Then here's our theme here, this Kingdom theme. So let's go back to the website and go to Appearance and Themes. Click Add New. Click Upload Theme. Navigate to where you downloaded and extracted the folder file thing. Select Kingdom. Click Install Now. So that theme was, there was a cost attached to it, it was $23. Again, I always recommend premium themes. I have used a few free themes, but I just find you need the support and you need the updates and the kind of functionality that you get from a premium theme. So again, $23 is not a lot. Hopefully you learn that back relatively quickly once you get your affiliate site up and running. So yeah, definitely worth the investment. Anyway, that's installed. So if we click Activate, we're done. And it's now going to recommend that we install some plugins. So might as well begin installing plugins. And I'm going to tick this box here to select all of them. I'm going to click Install on the drop down and then select Apply. Then we're done. Just click Return to the Plugins Installer. There shouldn't be anything here. Says they're all installed but not activated, so let's just tick your box again and click Activate. There was something there, I lied. So they're just activating. And we're all done. So I'm just gonna click up here and go Visit Site just to have a look at what's happened at the front. And we can see the website's already starting to look a bit different to the default theme. So we're now ready to start setting up the plugin and customizing the site to make it look like our own and get some products on here so that we can start making some money on Amazon. Okay, so the first thing that I wanna do is make the site look a bit more zombie-ish, because as I said, we're gonna be promoting some zombie products from Amazon. And obviously you wanna make your site your own. So the first thing I always do to make a site look like my own is change the logo. Now, if you haven't got a logo, that's fine. I've got a logo, which I've went and got from Graphic River. I'll show you it right now, actually. Graphic River is a great site. I'll put a little link up now. It's a great site for graphics that are very easy to change, but you will need some graphics editing software to do that. There are some free packages available online, but I've got the Adobe Creative Suite, which you can get for a monthly subscription. But yeah, I'm not gonna go into that now. But yeah, I purchased, if you go on here, you can do a search. So I did a search for zombie logo. And it brings up a whole load of things. I went for this one here. So that's what I'm gonna upload. I downloaded it, just customized the words, very easy, as I say, in Adobe Illustrator. And then I've got a logo. But if you don't want to be bothered with that, I've also got another video. Again, I'll put a link up on the screen now, which shows you how to make a video for free, which was produced by a guest on my channel. So maybe that would be suitable. And obviously, if you've already got a logo, then let's get it uploaded. So let's just close this and go back to the website. So I'm going to go into the dashboard. And I'm going to go to scroll down a bit and then Kingdom down here, which is the name of the theme we're running. And here's all the settings to do with the theme, and you know, we're gonna go through this one by one as we develop the site. But so the first thing is the logo, so that's in layout. And then click upload image, and you just find the image on your computer. Which is always easier said than done with my computer because I've got too much junk on here. Okay, so there's my logo. Then we click Insert into Post. And then we'll click Save the Settings. Now if we go back to the front of the website, we can see if that's worked. There's the logo. A zombie merc, which should have been merch, but hey, I'm over that now. Okay, so let's change some colors. I want to kind of have a, obviously this green and black effect that we've got going on with the logo. I want to kind of replicate that across the site. So to change the colors, we go back into the dashboard. And then we go back into the Kingdom settings. Then we go back to layout and then we can go to colors. So I've got my colors just to hand in my notes here, which I got from the logo using the little dripper tool that you're probably familiar with. If you use any graphics packages, you can just select a little dripper and it or dropper, and click on a color and it'll tell you what the hex number is, and that's what I need here. So let's see what happens. I'm gonna go for the primary color of green. At the moment it's set to red, so I'm just gonna paste that color code in. It's gone for the green. The secondary color, I think I'll go for the darker color in my logo, which is nearly black. And then for the menu, I'm gonna put the normal state, which is when no one's like on the menu, that's fine. And then for the hover, which is when obviously someone hovers over the menu, I'm gonna put that to, well, let's go for the orange, eh? There's also a bit of orange in my logo, so let's save that. And again, let's go back to the front of the website and have a look. So now, yeah, that's gone green and green. And I think as we obviously start to add more things, you'll see more of the colors coming through. But now we need to start making this look a bit more like a shop. So let's do that next. Okay, so we're gonna start setting up the homepage so that it's got all our products and slider and all that sort of stuff going on. Now, before I go much further, I just wanted to point you in the direction of the documentation that comes with this theme, because you might need it. Hey, even I need to look at it sometimes. So you'll have a folder which has got the version number. My one is 1.6, which you know we just extracted earlier from the theme zip file that you downloaded from Code Canyon. And within here, you'll see that there is a documentation.pdf, and you can just open that up, and it's got lots of stuff about how to set up the theme. Now, what I'm going to look at is this homepage, because I'm going to need some short codes that are on here. I'm just going to copy and paste these things in a second. So yeah, check out the documentation, and you know you're going to need it for this next section. So go and open it up right now. So let's create our homepage and add the short code. Basically, what this short code is going to do is let us lay out some featured products like this. Obviously, we haven't got any products just yet, but we will have very soon. So we might as well do it right now. And then we'll also add the top kind of image area of the homepage. So let's go back to the website, and I'm still logged in, and I'm going to create a new page. I'm going to go to new and page, then I'm going to give the page a name. I'm going to call it homepage. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy and paste this code here, this Kingdom row, Kingdom box featured products thing. So I just press Control C on my keyboard, and I'm just going to paste it in like that. Then I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to select Revolution Slider, which we are going to go and set up in a second. So we're going to have to come back and select the slider we create. And I'm going to turn off the title. Once I'm done, I'm going to click Publish. Now, next step is we need to just set this page as the home page. So to do that, we're going to go to Settings and Reading. Then here, I'm going to select a static page, and then I'm going to select that home page. Like that. And we're going to come back and we'll set a blog page as well a bit later. Okay, so now if we go back to the front of the website, we've got the feature products. There's nothing coming up yet, and there's no slider coming up. So well, let's do that right now. We'll do the slider. So a slider is an area where you can, I'm just going back to the dashboard now. A slider is an area where you can obviously put images, and people can click through to certain areas of your website, or you can just have a single image that appears with some text, you know, that looks nice. It's really quite flexible, and we're going to be using Slider Revolution. So let's go into there now, which is down here, and then across the Slider Revolution. I'm going to create a new slider, and it's a default slider. Let's give it a name. I'm going to call it Homepage, and then I need to give it an alias again. I'll just call that Homepage 2. Not homepage 2, but homepage as well. So they're both homepage. Now I'm going to select a hero scene because I only want the one image to come up. I haven't got lots of images that I need to slide through just yet. So obviously this can be changed in the future. So I'm selecting hero scene. And then down here, I'm going to adjust these dimensions just so that it fits the image that I've got. I don't want an image that's too long. And I've already got a zombie style image that I'm going to use. And I know that the dimensions of that are 1240 by 400. Like that. I'm going to leave that to auto, and I don't need to touch anything else. So let's go down and click Save Settings. Now we need to create our first slide. of which there is only going to be one, as I said. I only want the one, but you can create as many as you like. So I'm going to set a image by clicking the background image toggle there and click change image. I'm going to upload one from my computer. So I've already got this already ready. Again, I downloaded an image from Graphic River and just edited it a little bit. And I've got it in here. There they are. It's a load of zombie faces with glowing eyes. Thought it looked quite cool. So I'm just going to insert that. And then here it is. And then what we can do is we can add some text over this. So I can go add layer, text. I can give it some words. So the only place for zombie merchandise. Okay. I can change the style up here. So there's some kind of predefined ones that you can use if you want to. So that one's like a white one. There's all sorts, really. Just gonna see if there's anything that I fancy. Not really, so I think I'm gonna do it myself. So I can set a font here. Okay, change it to whatever I like. I like, I think something like Arial is always quite nice. Maybe Arial Black. Again, you could play around with this as much as you like to get it. Oh yeah, that's better. I think it's a little bit too big, so we've got the size up here. Let's knock that down to like 60. Maybe it's still too big again. Let's knock it down to 50. Okay, if I want to get it in the center, I can click here and here. So it's nicely in the middle. Let's see what that looks like. So to save, there's a little disk, floppy disk icon up here, which is a bit of a funny icon, as we haven't seen a floppy disk for 20 years, but hey, that's save. So make sure you don't miss that and you click that. And now let's go back. Let's go back to the front of the website and have a look what's happened. So I'm going to click visit site. Nothing's happened yet because we need to set the slider. So I'm going to click edit page. And here it's already kind of defaulted to that. So I think we just need to save that by clicking update. And if we click view page, there is our slider, which looks all right, or our hero scene. So now the website is starting to take place, and really what it needs to take shape. Sorry about that. We really need to add some products so that we can kind of start filling out the shop, add some navigation and categories and all that sort of stuff. So let's go on and add some products. Okay, so before we can start adding products, you're going to need to make sure that you've got an Amazon Associates account. Which, if you've got one already, great. If you haven't, I'll show you how you can get one. So you go across to your local Amazon site. Mine is amazon.co.uk. Yours might be amazon.com. And then what you need to do is scroll down to the bottom and you'll find the Associates program. Click through to there. I'm already signed up, so it takes me straight through. For you, it will take you through a form that you need to fill in and complete a few bits of information, and then you'll be set up as well and you'll be ready to go. Now in here we can find everything we need in order to configure our website. So I'm just going to go back to the website and go into the settings that we need to look at. So back into the dashboard, down to Woozone, and then into Amazon config, and then we can start setting up these things. You can leave this to worldwide, or if you're going to be working in a particular country, you can obviously set the Amazon location there. I'm going to leave that worldwide. Okay, so to get our access key ID, you need to click this link here, which says AWS account management. And again, if you're not signed up, you'll need to sign up. You can just sign in with your Amazon account, I believe. So I'm just going to sign in now. Okay, let's click continue to security credentials. And then what we need is these access keys. So I've got a few in here that I've already got. You obviously won't have any, so you'll need to click create new access key. What you can then do is copy and paste the key, obviously, into the access key ID. When you create your key, you will get your secret as well. Unfortunately, because I've already created my keys, because I've got another affiliate site already up and running, obviously, I'm unable to see the secret, but I do have it to hand anyway. So let me just paste that in from another website. But you'll get it obviously when you create your access key. So going back, I'm going to paste that secret access key in like so. Now in here, this is where we add our affiliate IDs. I often add one just to the US and UK. Again, you get these back in your Amazon Affiliate Center. So I'm going to go back to there now by going to Amazon. And then again, scroll down to the bottom, Associates Program. And you can see the ID is up here and you can manage these. You can create different ones if you've got multiple websites, for example. So I'll create a new one. I'm going to call it Zombie Merc. Continue. And then I can simply copy and paste this in like this, into there and into there. I'm going to set my main affiliate ID as UK because that is where I am. Obviously, you set it to whatever yours is. And then I'm going to click check. And it says they were able to connect, so that seems fine. Let's click save. It says I've got a number of available countries, so that's pretty good. I could probably then enter this into other places. So Germany, France, that way if you get customers from other countries, you'll still be able to get paid. So Japan, Canada, China. I don't know if Chinese people are into zombies, maybe. Zombies are big everywhere, I'd have thought. Italy. Where's Spain? There's Spain. And India. Perfect. So I'm just going to save that. Right, now we're ready to start adding some products, I think. Let's just go through these last settings. So the plugin setup, you can go through here and change all sorts of things if you want. So turn off the on-site cart. I'm going to leave all these as default for now, and if we need to touch them, that's fine. Okay, so let's start adding some products. Before we can do that, we need to think about some product categories. Now you have the choice when you're importing to import the categories from Amazon. I wouldn't recommend this because the Amazon categories can be quite messy and there's quite a lot of them. I would suggest that you think of your own categories that you want and add them yourself. So for example, for my zombie products, I want a category for books and toys and games and all those sort of things. So have a think about the categories that you're going to need and then you can add them. I will just stress that I've added this section of the video at the end because I missed it out. So let's just do it very quickly and I'll show you where it is and then we'll go back to kind of where we were. Sorry about that, but it should be fine. So to add our categories, we go to products and categories. The first category that I added was books, which you'll see as we continue the video in a second. But in here, yeah, you want to add the categories that you need. And obviously you can do it as you go along as you're importing products. So don't worry if you can't think of them all now. So you just simply fill in these boxes to add a category. So for example, if it was books, you type in books. You don't have to worry about the slug. You probably don't have to worry about the parent unless you were going, for example, like here with DVDs, that might fit under videos. And you'd obviously set the videos as the parent for the DVD category. You can add a description if you like, but again, that's not always necessary. And then you click add new product category. So once you've added a couple of categories, you then need to start the import. And to do that, we go to Woozone and then Insane Mode Import. So let's type in zombie. Let's select a category of books. We can select best selling or whatever in terms of the sort. We can grab the first page, the first two pages, first three pages, first four pages. Let's go for the first five pages. That will give us a good bulk, I think. And then let's click launch search. And it goes off to Amazon and does some searching. And here we go. We've got lots of what look like good zombie books. Some fine tuning here. You can select how many images you want to download. And when you want to download them, I'm going to leave it as download images import. The asynchronous kind of tries to do it in the background, I believe. and you can import attributes. And then there's this button here which says spin on import, which will kind of change the text on the description so that it's not exactly the same as Amazon, to give you a little bit of unique content. So I'm going to click that, but obviously it will slow things down. And then I'm going to select that I want to import these into the books category. That's very important. And yeah, we've got 50 products here, so let's give that a go. I'm going to click this. It says it's going to do 23 products a minute, so by my calculations, that's going to take a couple of minutes. So let's click the button. 1 minute 45, I was close. So let's let this do this, do its thing. And yeah, again, I'll do another quick edit to save you some time. And I'll be back in a second and we'll see how it's gone. Okay, so that took a couple of minutes and it's finished and it's got 50 of the 50 products in. So let's go and have a look what's happened. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add the books category to a menu so that we can easily access it from the front. So I'm going to go to appearance and menus. So as you add new categories, you're going to want to add them obviously to the navigation so people can find them, and this is where we do it. So we need to create a new menu. I'm going to call it the main menu, or main menu, don't need the, and click create menu. And I'm going to call this the main tick main navigation, because that's where it's going to sit. There's two locations on this theme, the top and the main. The top is obviously across the top, which we can add some stuff to later. But for now, we're just worried about the main navigation, and then I'm going to come down here. What I'm looking for is the product categories, which isn't here. So if it's not here for you either, you need to scroll to the top and then you need to go to screen options. And here it is here. I'm going to tick product categories and then there we go. It's appeared and there's our books. Let's click add to menu and then save menu. So now if we go back to our website, here's the navigation starting to appear. And if we click books, here is all our zombie books. Now notice that obviously that first one is not a zombie related book, so we can change that. But if we click through, there we go. It's got all the content nicely formatted. And yeah, loads of other kind of get your copy, whatever, frequently bought together stuff and recommended related products. It's all starting to look really good. So I'm going to go and add a few more products and to some more categories. And I'll take you through a couple of them and then I'll kind of do the rest so that fill out the website. You don't have to watch me do all of them, obviously. And then we'll move on to kind of customizing the site a bit further and really making it come alive. So I'll show you another category, as I said. I'm going to show you, I'm going to do video games now. So let's go back to the dashboard. And I'm going to create a category first under products and categories. Call it video games. Add new product category. There we go. Then I'm going to go back into, obviously I could add more books as well if I wanted to, which I may do later. But let's go back into Woozone and go into insane mode import, which is a great name for a feature of a plugin, I think. Again, I'm going to do a search for zombie. And then in categories, I'm going to scroll down and go to video games. And I'm going to go for the first 5 pages. Oh, what the hell, let's go for first 10 pages. You can't have too many products, I don't think. I'm going to do that search, which is going to take a few minutes. And that's done. There's our products, Xbox games and PlayStation games and all sorts of nice things. Again, I'm going to tick the spin on import and select the category video games and then click import. And let's do a quick edit and speed this whole process up. Okay, so that's all finished. So again, I'm going to add the new category to the menu. So let's go into appearance and menus. And then again, scroll down to product categories, select the new category. It's there, added to menu. Let's click save menu. Okay, and then if we go back to our website again, we can see that video games is there. If we click through, we can see there's all our zombie related video games. Now you may spot products as we did in books that aren't relevant. And again, you can just go into the back end here, into the dashboard, go into products, and then it lists all the products that you've imported so far. And if you see anything that isn't particularly zombie related, these all look zombie related. Say this doesn't look particularly, it's an urban camo thing, PS4 controller, but if I didn't want that, I could just click the trash button like this. And then that's gone. So let's just go back to the front of the site. What I'm going to do is I'm going to import some more categories in a second, but before I do that, I want to just change this navigation. It kind of blends in with the header. I think it needs an extra color. So to do that, I'm going to go back into the dashboard, go into the theme settings, which again is Kingdom. Click on layout, go to colors, and this menu background color, I'm going to set that to be the green color. So again, I've got my note, and the green color is this one, so I'm just going to copy and paste that in. Click save, go back to the front of the website to have a look. And there we go. Although this text I think would be better white, so let's just correct that. I'm just going to go back to those settings by clicking back into colors, and I'm going to change this to white, the normal state color. Just going to click on the white there, click save. Let's have a look how that looks. That's looking all right now. Okay, so I will add some more products into different categories and add them all to the menu to fill out the site a bit more, and then we'll go on configuring all the other bits and bobs that we need to do. Okay, so I've been busy importing lots of products using the insane product importer, and it didn't actually take too long, so that's good news. As you can see, I've got a few categories now, books, clothes and costumes, which on hindsight, maybe I should have broken down a little bit more because there's a lot of zombie costumes and clothes, and obviously maybe that might be better in two separate categories, but for now I'm happy with that. I did then create another category called t-shirts and just search for zombie t-shirts because I thought, you know, that's probably more popular than toys and videos and video games, and yeah, that was about it for me. I couldn't really find any other zombie stuff, but that is plenty. So if you click through, obviously you can check how all the products are, and some of them may need a little bit of tidying up. Oh, excuse the profanity there. I didn't know that Amazon had such rude things. Have a look through your products, make sure all the pictures look fine, a lot of these look great. But sometimes you do get a few funnies. I'm just gonna see if I can find one. Like this one here, where it's brought through like the size guide image as the main image. So to correct that, you can just go into the product. Now when you're logged into WordPress, it's very easy to edit any section by just coming up to this top toolbar here. So I can click edit product on this page. And then if we scroll down, we can see that this is the featured image, and yeah, it's the kind of size guide thing going on, which we don't really want. So we can click remove product image. And we just want to set this this one as the product image. So let's click set product image. And it brings up all the images that you've got on your website, which is obviously quite a lot after you've been doing product imports like I have. So if we go to this drop down and select uploaded to this product, it will just show us this one, which is fine. That's all we want. Click set product image. There it is. Click update and that will be all right. So yeah, you might want to just go through all your products and just make sure that they look okay. Let's click view product. There we go, perfect. And all the size details and everything have come across nicely. So it's perfect. Let's just double check it works. Click add to cart. There we go, it's been added to the cart. We can then view cart. And it's done. Obviously, then if we click proceed to checkout, we should go off to Amazon if it's all still working. Okay, so what I've just noticed is that obviously I set my currency on WooCommerce to pounds because I'm in the UK. But then I left the Amazon site set as worldwide. So what it's done is it's imported lots of products from Amazon.com, which is fine, but they're obviously all in dollars. And obviously my currency is in pounds, so there's a little bit of a mismatch there. So what I've decided, what I'm going to do, as it's a .com website, I'm just going to go for dollars and list everything in dollars. Now, if you decide that you want to change currency, here's what you do, and here's what I've just done. Basically, what you need to do is go into your backend and go into WooCommerce and Settings. I'm just going to open that new tab, and we'll go back to that tab in a second, and I'll tell you why. Come down here and set your currency. So I've just switched mine over to US dollars. But then if you do that, obviously, you're going to need to update all the prices on your products, because they're going to obviously been downloaded in the currency that you originally set. For me, that was British pounds. So I've changed it here, click save. Then what I've done is in this tab, which is still running, I've come into, I don't know why that menu is still popped out. Oh, there we go, it's gone. What I've done is I've come into Woozone and then gone under plugin status and synchronization log. And then what you can do is in here, as well as setting up the synchronization, which is basically every day you can get the website to go up and check prices and descriptions and all that kind of stuff, which is useful. By default, it's set to do every day, so you can come in here and set that up as you'd like. And then all I've done is click sync all now, which is this green button here. It's slightly faded because I say it is syncing right now. And what that does is it goes back to Amazon and it updates all the prices, so they're all okay. So yeah, sorry about that, but obviously I'm kind of doing this as we go, and you know, I'm going to make the odd little mistake, and if you do too, as I've just shown, it's quite easy to put right. So I'll leave this syncing in the background, and we'll crack on sorting out the rest of the homepage. Okay, so what I want to do next is add some products to here, just below the slide. We've already got this featured products area, but at the moment we haven't got any featured products, so that'd be a good thing to do first of all. So to do that, let's go back to the dashboard. And then let's go to the products. Now, I find the easiest way to do it is from this page, the products page, which is just loading up. And you'll see that there's a column here with a little star. That is the featured column. So I can just start ticking that star to make some things featured. Obviously, you can decide exactly what you want to go for. That's a t-shirt. So that's one star. Let's pick something else. Gift set. Once you click, you have to wait a second for it to do it. Let's scroll down and find something else. A lot of t-shirts. So if you want to go into different category, you can just go to categories. Oh, actually, there's a drop down there. I just saw it. Never noticed that before. But let's go into books. You see this count number over here. I can just click that and it'll show me all the posts or products that are in books. So let's pick that one. Just a random Minecraft book. Walking Dead book. I do love the Walking Dead. Okay, I think that's three we've done now. You probably want to do, you know, 5, 6, 7 featured products. Let's go into another one. Let's go into toys. That is probably an easy way to change category. I've learned something myself today. I didn't even notice that drop down. And all these years I've been using WordPress. Hey ho. Oh, I need to click filter. So here's some toys, and that looks good. Little collector's thing, whatever that is. A zombie shark, wow, look at that, let's add that. Okay, I think you get the point. Let's go back and have a look at the homepage and see if those featured products have appeared where they should. Okay, so we've got the one here, which is a bit peculiar. So let's just edit the page and see what's going on with that. Ah, I see it's this column setting here. It's only set to one. I think probably four columns is what we need. So let's click update. And view page. And it's still not working. Let's go back in and have another look. I'm not going to edit this out. I think I'm going to leave this interview so you can see the process that even, you know, people like me that have done lots of WordPress websites, there's still things that kind of don't go quite right and you're not quite sure why. But now as I look at this, I can see the problem. You see these speech marks. We copied this from the documentation that came with the theme earlier in the video, if you remember. Like, I see that these speech marks are all weird. That's a weird one and that's not right. So I'm just going to take those out and put some normal ones in. And I'm pretty sure that's going to fix our little problem. So there we go. And I'm going to go for a few more of these, what are called short codes, in a second on how we can build up the homepage and add, like, you know, products from other categories and stuff like that. So that's updated. Let's have a look. And fingers crossed, our products are going to appear in four columns. Here we go. And there's a little slider action going on there as well. So that's great. And then what we can do is we can add some more rows so that we can, you know, show off some of the products from some of the other categories. So to do that, let's go back into the page. Now what I've done, I've got this other tab open here. I've just did a quick Google for WooCommerce shortcodes because the e-commerce platform that is powering the site kind of behind the affiliate plugin is obviously WooCommerce. And there's a whole load of shortcodes that come with WooCommerce. Now a shortcode, if we open this link here, which I've got open in here, a shortcode is like our feature products one that we put on a minute ago. Basically just a small thing that you can copy and paste and it then, you know, triggers something to happen. And in this case, show the feature products. But there are some other ones. So, you know, you can show a particular product if you wanted on a page and all these other wonderful things. But what I want to do is show some categories. We're going to use this one called product category. So I'm just going to copy that short code. And then I'm going to paste it in here. Now I want some of this other row stuff that we've got. So I'm just going to, you know, I want to use that again. I want a headline. So I'm just going to copy and paste. I love copy and paste, as you'll discover if you watch my videos. And we'll use the category toys to start with. So I've changed that there to toys. So that word that you put in there has to be the category slug. And to find that, I'll just show you how you find that. So if you go into products and categories, I'll open it in a new tab so we don't lose what we're doing here. And you'll see the slug here. So it's normally the same word, but if it's two words, there's often a hyphen in between. So toys is fine. So let's go back. And I'm going to call this zombie toys. And again, we can use the same sort of whatever these are, attribute type things as on the feature product. So per page 6, but in fact we could have even more. Let's have 12. Let's put that to 12 as well, although we don't have 12 feature products, but if we added some more, they would then appear. And then we just need to finish off by copying this closing tag. You can tell it's closing because it's got a slash. So this basically creates the rows within the theme. So don't worry too much, but as long as it's all, if you start with a kingdom row, you have to end with a slash one at the end. I'm not going to get too bogged down in all the short codes because it can get a bit techy. But yeah, just copy and paste what you've got and then you can create more. Let's have a look. Hopefully we'll have another row of toys now. And there's our zombie toys. So we'll add one more category, I think, to fill out this homepage. Okay, so we obviously need to click edit page again. Then I'm just going to copy this one that we just added, paste it below. I'm going to call it zombie books. Change the category to books. Click update. Then view page. If we scroll down, there's our toys and there's our books. So it's starting to look really good now. So the next thing I want to do is, if you look at the products, I'm just going to click on this t-shirt here and have a look at it. There's a space here down the right hand side for a sidebar. So basically we can drop some things in there. So I think we should go and do that right now. So if we go back into the dashboard, and then go to Appearance and Widgets. We can find here is the shop sidebar. So basically whatever we add here will then appear in that sidebar area. So there's a number of different widgets you can add, and you can just literally just kind of drag and drop these elements over. So there's some nice WooCommerce ones along here. So for example, we might want to show off the featured products. So to do that, we would go get the WooCommerce products one, drag that up, and would select featured products, and then give it a title. Leave it at 5, click save. Let's go back to the front of the website and see what's happened. Let's click on that t-shirt again. You can see that our featured products are here, which is good. Let's add another widget. So let's go back. I think we can just click widgets here if you want to go back the shortcut way. Yep, so that's our featured product one. The next one I'm going to add is another WooCommerce products one, but I want to show products on sale. Just call it products on sale. Then I'm going to select show on sale products. Save. But obviously you can add whatever you like to these sidebars. You might want to add a banner image, you might want to add a search box, so it's already got one. You can add just some plain text, really whatever you like. So you have a good play around with these and kind of customize it as you see fit. So let's go back to the site, check that product, it's feature products, there's the products on sale. Perfect, so it's starting to come together now really nicely. What I want to do now is finish configuring this kind of header area, tidy that up, change the phone number if need be, if you've got a phone number, if you want to, or you can change this to whatever writing you like. So to do that, we need to go back into the dashboard. And go into Kingdom again, our theme settings. And then into layout. And then we need to go across to the footer, weirdly, even though it's in the header. We could start changing stuff in the header and footer. So I don't have a phone number for this particular site, but I know you can set up an 0800 number if you want on Skype, you know, or whatever number. So that's sometimes, but I don't have one right now. So I'm just gonna change this. So to change it, obviously just click in here and you can change it to whatever you want. Just anything random I'm gonna put for all your zombie needs. Perfect. Right, you can change the copyright text at the bottom. I'm gonna change that to me, WP Eagle, link to the website. It's very nice. There's a whole load of other stuff you could put in here if you want. I don't have any of this stuff right now, so I'm just gonna leave that. I do want to set up my social icons though while I'm here, so let's go into social setup, and here you can put your Facebook stuff in. Again, I haven't set one up for this particular site, so I'm just going to leave it with that, but then when I do, I'll come in and put, you know, slash zombie. It'll probably be something like that anyway, I'll fill it in. And it's the same with Twitter. So you just copy and paste your full thing. YouTube, I do have one of them. Here we go, WordPress Eagle. That'll do for now, let's click save. So let's go back to the site. We'll see that that's changed to for all your zombie needs. There's our social media icons. Down the bottom, our message there has changed. So these are the links that it's asking about for Visa and PayPal and stuff. If you have them, you can add them. Okay, so, just looking here, this bottom area looks a little bit of a mess. So this is the footer area. So let's go and change that now. Now again, I think these are widgets. So if we go into widgets, And here's our footer content now. I don't want the search. I don't want recent posts. I don't want recent comments. I don't want any of these really. I like to add, again, more product related things and kind of links. So let's start by actually adding some text. Just a little text that says, you know, welcome. Oh no, let's put about. And then you'd put some blah, blah, blah in here. Actually, I will type something. We're an Amazon associate powered website that brings you the best zombie products from across Amazon. You put what you want and then click save. The next one I'm going to have the product categories. Just going to call it zombie products. And I'm going to order by name, that's fine. Let's click save. What else should we have? Let's have a top rated products, that sounds good. Perfect, and I think just one more because there's normally four columns. Actually, what I want to do is add a menu. So what I'll do is I'll come back to that in a second because I need to add some more pages. So let's see what that looks like for now with the free. There we go, it's looking good apart from, that's probably a bit too long. So let's just adjust that. That to two. So yeah, speaking of those other pages, let's do that now. So if we go into pages, let's see what we've got. So there's not a lot going on. There's a sample page, which isn't very exciting. Let's trash that. And then there's just our home page and our shop pages. So let's add some new pages. So an about us, very important. Let's add another one, let's add a contact page. We'll fill all the content in on these in a minute. And let's also add a some other important kind of housekeeping type pages like a privacy policy. If you don't have a privacy policy, you can just find one by Googling it. That's all I generally do when for sites like this. Maybe a terms and conditions. Again, they kind of make it look important and you can put whatever you want in here. Again, you'll find what you need for these on the internet. And finally, I'm just going to add a page that will be our blog because I'll touch on this later, but blogging is going to be quite important in terms of getting your word out to everyone and trying to get some search engine rankings. You're going to need to do a few blog posts, so you're going to need a blog. So create a page called blog. There's a template here that says template blog, which is what we need to select for the blog page. Click publish. Now there's one last step you need to do with the blog to make it an actual blog, and that is to go to settings and reading. And this is where we set the home page, but here the post page is where we're going to select a blog. Now we need to add those pages to our menu. So let's go to appearance and menus. Now I think it's nice to add a home page to the menu, so let's do that first. Click add to menu. So I just selected it from left here. This is all our pages. I don't like it being called homepage, so I'm just going to call it home. You can obviously change the textures by clicking this little arrow. Let's add the blog and the contact us. That's perfect. Let's see what's happened. Let's go back to the website and have a look. There we go, looking good. It's starting to fill out that menu nicely. Now the other pages we can add to some other little menus. As I said, one for maybe the bottom down here where we've got our new widgets. There's a space here for a menu. And there's also a menu across the top that we can add. So let's do those now. Back into the dashboard. And appearance and menus. Let's click create a new menu. First one I'm going to do is the top menu. I'm going to call it top menu. I've obviously called many menus top menu as it kind of popped up in my suggested thing there when I was typing. And to this I'm going to add some of the kind of more boring-ish type pages. So let's add the about us. Let's add the my account. And let's add the, what else have we got? Where's my privacy policy thing gone? Don't know, we'll add the terms and conditions. The privacy policy has disappeared. I'll go and find it in a second. Then I'm going to select top navigation for those pages. Click save menu. And visit the site. There we go. Looking good. Let's just go back into the main, the dashboard and just have a quick look in the pages, find out where that privacy policy's gone. I obviously didn't save it properly. Let's just create it again. There we go. So I'm gonna go back into menus. Now I'm gonna create a third menu. This one is gonna be for the widget area. So again, create a new menu. I'm going to call it footer menu. Yeah, I'm just going to add a few more pages, the terms and conditions, the privacy policy, the contact us, the about us, and let's say the blog as well for good measure. So let's order these as we want. I think blog first, contact us, about us. There we go. Click save menu. Now we're not going to tick any of these boxes because we've already done our main menu and we've done our top menu. There is no other theme locations. But that's fine because we're gonna add this menu to a widget. Let's go back to widgets. And you'll find there's a widget called custom menu, this one right here. So let's drag that over to the footer. Let's call it more info. We can then select our footer menu that we just created. Click save. Let's go and have a look at our website. Scroll down, there's our more info. And it's looking really good now. It's starting to come together quite nicely, isn't it? So the next thing we should do is have a look at that contact page. If we go over here to the contact us, there's obviously nothing on it right now, so let's click edit page. Then obviously in here we can type some text, so get in touch if you have any questions. Using the form below, which is fine, but we just need to add a form. So let's just save this page by clicking update over here. And then when we set up the plugin, it installed a plugin. When we installed the theme and the plugin earlier, all that stuff, it did install some other plugins, and one of them is this contact plugin here. So if we go over to contact forms, should be a form that's already created, which there is. And it's got a short code. Again, talking about short codes earlier, and it's a good way of inserting things. If we copy this one, it will be a form. So let's just copy that into the clipboard. I'm gonna go into edit and just double check what the form looks like. So it's pretty straightforward. It's just got a name, email, subject, message, and send, which is fine. You can go through here, and it's gonna obviously put the to address and everything, which will be your admin address that we set up earlier. You can kind of change all that, and there's some other settings which you can play around with if you wish, which we don't need to right now. Let's just save it. I've already got that short code, this short code here, clop it into my clipboard. So let's go back to pages, into the contact us page. Let's paste it, click update. If we view this page, there's a lovely looking form, which is perfect. And obviously you could add your phone number, maps, whatever you like if you need to, but obviously as it's an affiliate site, probably don't want to put too much info on there. You don't want people ringing you up all the time. If they've got a problem, they can contact Amazon, can't they? Good, so that's the contact page all done. We've done the sidebars. We've done the menus, and generally the site is starting to look pretty, pretty cool. So what I'll do is I'm going to take this opportunity now and we'll just double check the rest of our Amazon settings just to make sure that they're all good to go. And then finally, I'm just going to touch on adding a blog post and SEO. But hold tight, you are nearly at the end and hopefully your website is starting to look really good and you're excited about adding lots of products and the prospect of making lots of money with Amazon, all being well. Obviously, results will vary. Okay, so let's go back in and go through our Amazon settings just one last time and just double check that we haven't missed anything. So I'm going to go into Woozone here. I think we're all good to go, to be fair, but let's just double check. So we did all our Amazon config first. We did all the basics. So you generally aren't going to need to mess with this too much, but you can if you want. So, you know, the on-site cart, you can turn off if you want. I think it's really good because it allows people to add more than one product, which is good, and then it dumps them all into the Amazon checkout when they go across. If you set that to no, obviously people will be sent straight off as soon as they select a product. This is whether it opens Amazon in a new tab or not. It's up to you. 90-day cookie is good, which means if they go to Amazon from your website and then in 90 days' time they buy something, you'll still get some commission. Cross-selling is good. You can turn the gallery on and off if you want. All sorts of things. It's turned off at the moment because there is the gallery anyway. That would add it to the description. So again, generally, default settings are probably fine. You can increase the speed that it redirects. You can change the button by text if you like. It's kind of really easy to make it your own. The import setting is fine. You can decide about attributes, which is more important if you're doing things like clothes and stuff like that. But generally, as I say, all these settings are fine unless you really need to change anything. I just wanted to just double check. The spin is set to no, but you might want to set it to yes. So that's when it changes the copy. Sometimes it can make it a little bit random because it uses like a thesaurus to change the words. So some people think that's good for SEO. Some people don't. Again, it's up to you. You probably want to look into that. So that's all looking good. Let's go into plugin status. I just want to show you that sync log again. So this is where you can set up your syncing and all that sort of stuff. Mine is, I think it's still syncing some stuff since I changed those prices. It just does it in the background. But you can, I would recommend that you probably sync every day, but that's going to depend on how, you know, how often you think the products change and things like that. But generally every day should be fine. So you will want to check out that page. Let's go through these other ones just very quickly. The assets download is if there's a problem with it downloading images, they'll show up here and you can force it to download them. Nothing to worry about in there at the moment. Product stats, I believe, is just your kind of product stats. It shows you how many people have looked at stuff. I have been looking at the zombie books a little bit, so it's given me 4 hits, but shows you if they've added to cart or if they're redirected, so that's quite interesting details. Plugin cron jobs is when it's doing the kind of auto sync stuff. So if there's a problem in here, it will show in here. Again, probably don't need it unless you've got an issue. Here's a problem. Here's the Amazon debug. So again, if you're getting problems with Amazon, you can have a look in here. I haven't, so I don't need to look. And here's just your log of everything that it's been doing. And the last one is your server status, which is full of all sorts of interesting stuff. It's saying that we should update the memory limit, which you can do if you just ask HostGator, but it's not that important right now. Okay, so I'm happy with all those Amazon settings, and you probably don't need to change any of them too, unless you really like customizing stuff, in which case, you know, get stuck in. So we added a blog earlier, so let's add a blog post. So to do that, we go to posts and add new. Now, I will say that, as I said earlier, that blog posts are going to be important. It's a way of updating your site with fresh content that's not just products. You know, you can add something better. So you might do a blog post like, you know, our favorite zombie films of all time. I mean, they don't always have to be product related. They could be, you know, like this, film related, and then you might want to link through to some of the products that are related to films. Of course, I've got t-shirts and things. So you'd start typing in here. Number one is 28 days later, Then you might put some blurb, you know, we love this film, it's really great. And yada, yada, yada. I'm not going to write a whole blog post during this video because I think that would be very boring. You can add it to a category, which is always good to keep things nice and neat. So let's call it zombie films. And then you can add a nice picture here. So I need to quickly Google one. I'm just going to Google over here and type in 28 days later. And go to Google Images. I will say you need to be careful when you get images from Google because you may not have the rights to do it, but you know, generally you'll be fine. Let's just save this image as, sorry, not copy. Save that into somewhere where I can find it. Let's call it 28 days. Go back to our blog post, and then I'm going to go to Set Featured Image. Upload files, select file, go back to the folder, which never seems to be the one I was in on this Mac. I don't know why. Upload that. It's done. Click Set Featured Image. And then click Publish. So now if we go to our blog, we'll see this really long blog post that I wrote. So we can go View Post. There's our post. It's featured image and the text, of which there isn't much. Again, we can add a sidebar to the blog, which we'll do in a second, a similar way to what we did to the shop. Click on blog. It'll be there, and obviously this will then list all the rest of the posts. We've got this post here called Hello World, which is the default WordPress post, which I'm just going to click edit and delete because it's a bit boring. I'm going to do one more blog post just to fill it out a little bit more so you can get the idea of how it will look. Let's our favorite zombie TV. Let's go easy, isn't it? Walking Dead. It's fantastic. And then, of course, you would write lots more words and write a proper article. But as I said, I don't want to bore you to death. So let's just get this done. Zombie TV. Let's get a quick picture of The Walking Dead. Perfect. And go back to our blog post. Set featured image. Load files. The Walking Dead. That image is quite big, so it tells you how big, 513 kilobits, and it's quite large, so should be fine. But obviously, the bigger the image, the slower your website will be. So, you know, smaller images are generally better for speed. So, have a look at the post. That's good. If you go to the blog, say it's like listing them quite nicely, which is all good. So, let's add a sidebar quickly to the blog. And again, we'll go to the widgets. And in here, you've got this blog sidebar, so we could add some blog type stuff, categories, blog categories. We might want to add recent comments, which there probably isn't any just yet, but there might be in the future. And let's see what else that might be useful. If you're going to tag, you could have a tag cloud. So you can tag up posts, so you know that, so that then it knows like relevant stuff. So you might tag a post like just random words that relate. So Walking Dead, you'd tag it Walking Dead, zombies, TV, AMC, you know, whatever you can think of, and it's kind of helps people find stuff. So let's click save. Let's go back to the website. Let's go back to the blog and then go into a blog post. There we go, we haven't got any recent comments or tags just yet. So let me just show you what a tag would look like. Let's click on edit post. Go to tags and we'll tag it zombie, Walking Dead, TV, drama. That'll do for now. A few tags, I'm separating them all with commas as you can see. Click update. There's the tags, and obviously as you add more tags to different posts, they'll all sort of appear there and people can click them and then find all the posts related to that tag. I wanted to add a comment so we can see if that's working. If we click edit post. By default, comments seem to be off on this site, so what you need to do to turn comments on a particular blog post, if we go up to screen options and select discussion, it adds a little tick box here that needs to be ticked which says allow comments. Let's click update. Now if you want to enable them across the whole site, you'd go into settings, discussion. And you need to tick allow people to post comments on new articles and click save changes. So if we go back to the site and back to our blog, click on the blog post. See, there's a comment. And we can add one. Post comment. And then they're going to appear nicely below the blog post so people can like discuss stuff. There we go. And it's got built-in social share and all kinds of good stuff. And then we see the recent comments are appearing here. So that's the blog almost done. What we can do is add recent posts to the homepage, which might be quite nice. And to do that, we're going to need a short code one more time. So let's click edit page. And then I'm going to go back to the documentation that came with the theme, which I've got open here. And if we scroll down, here we go, there is a little blog post thing here, shortcode. Let's just copy that back to our page, paste it at the bottom, set to free per page, that's fine. Click update. I'm going to make it capitals to match the rest of the titles. I'm going to change it to latest zombie blog posts. Then click view page. Let's scroll down. There's our latest blog post, looking good. Okay, so we are nearly at the end of the video. The last thing I want to talk to you about is SEO, because the success of this website is going to be down to how much traffic you get from Google organic search. And to help you with your SEO, I'm only going to touch on this in this video, but I do have some other videos on my channel all about SEO. But the one plugin you are going to want to install is, if we go to dashboard and install it, it's called Yoast SEO. So let's go to plugins and add new. And type Yoast SEO into the search box on the add plugin screen. Click install now. Click activate. What this plugin does is it makes it very easy for you to optimize your categories, your products, and all sorts of things. So if we pick a random product, and I'm not gonna, you don't really need to do this on every product to be fair, but I'm just gonna use this as an example. You can scroll down and you can see what it's going to look like on Google. And you can kind of set a focus keyword. So you can type in, you know, zombie devil as your focus keyword. Then it gives you a little score. And that can be green, yellow, or red, depending on how well optimized it is. So you might want to come up here and add that word a few more times and kind of follow all these tips to help you optimize your SEO. What I'll do is I'll add a link to the a video that I've got all about Yoast SEO to this video right now, so that you can go off and do that. But one thing you are going to want to check is the names of your categories, especially. So if you go into categories on here, so for example, this books one, let's click edit. At the moment it's called books archives, which is not great. So let's call it zombie books. So zombie books is our focus keyword, and then we can come up here and we can click on the pencil, change that to zombie books. Add some more words if you want, because it's going to appear on Google, hopefully. Huge range. And then we can change the meta description to huge range of zombie books from a wide range of authors for all age ranges. Well, maybe not all age ranges. Because it is zombies after all, let's say 16 to... No, let's not put ages at all. Wide range of authors. Check out our collection. That'll do. Not feeling too creative today. And then click update. Okay, so let's have one final look at the website. Okay, there is just one last thing, and I do promise this is the very last thing, and then we'll wrap this video up. And that is we need to add the text to those little pages that we added. So I'll just show you a couple of them. So for example, the About Us page. Let's just edit the page. I've got some text in my Word document just here, so I'm just going to copy and paste it in. Yep. Here it is. Don't need that About Us. Make that one bold. Again, obviously, you'd fill this out and put in as much info as you like, maybe a picture as well to make it good. So let's have a look at that. Yeah, that page probably needs to be a bit more, but I'll do that later. You don't need to watch me do that. I've also got a privacy policy here, which is just a generic one. Feel free to use it if you like. So let me just copy and edit. Paste that in, nice and easy. There we go. And there is one final feature that I'm just going to do just so that you can do it as well if you want to. We can have a list of, or even a kind of column type row of icons of like the partners and the stuff that we're promoting. So I thought we'd add a few of them, just see what they look like, just to finish off the site nicely. So to do that, let's go back to the dashboard. If we go to partners, there's nothing in it just yet. So let's click add new partner. And we can give it a title. I've got a Lego one, so let's say Lego. These are just images that I found on the website. I don't know if they're gonna be the right size. Hopefully they will be. If not, we'll have to do a resize of some sort, but let's see what happens. There's Lego. Insert into post. I'm not going to put a partner link just now, but you could maybe add an Amazon affiliate link through to your Lego stuff, but I'll leave that for now. Let's go back to the homepage, see what that looks like. There it is. So let's add a few more. So partners, add new partner. I've got a Walking Dead one, of course. So yeah, just inserting these as images, click insert into post, click publish. There we go, I think you get the idea. Let's see what this one looks like. It's kind of cut it off a little bit and whatnot. And it's added a weird white background as well, which is a bit funny. But so you may want to use it, you may not. But I'm going to add a few more. You don't need to watch me do that. I'll do that offline. And I think that is all done. I'm happy to say this website is ready. I mean, obviously you will work on it as you go forward. You'll probably add extra bits and bobs, tweak it, whatever, make it your own. But I'm happy with how far we've got with this, and hopefully you are too. So that's the end of this video. If you got this far, well done. Not many people do make it this far in my videos because they are quite long. But if you have, then congratulations. I hope your website is good. I'd love for you to share what you've made with me, and obviously leave it in the comments below this video or send me a message, whatever you like. Equally, if you haven't got this far and you've got stuck and whatever and you need some help, then please drop me a message again via email or in the comments below this video, and I'll do my best to help you out. Of course, you can get support from the theme or from the plugin developer via Code Canyon, where you purchased them from earlier, and I found them to be very helpful. So yeah, that might be your first point of call if you can't get something working. If you like what I'm doing, then please click like on this video and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Have a look around my channel because I've got a lot more videos about WordPress and SEO and all sorts of things that I think you might find useful. But until next time, I'm going to wish you good luck and see you later and bye for now.